那就是今天晚上的特别嘉宾耶。Hello.
Hello, my name is Andrew Chow.
Andrew, you must sit in a bit.
Okay,
you must be more intimate tonight.
Yes, that's right, that's right.
两个大男人好像很 intimate， 其实是很 shy 的，对不对？
对对对对对。We have a man's talk tonight.
Hey, Andrew, can you speak Mandarin?
我试试看吧。
By the way, 我想跟你讲哎，My interview is coming from Mandarin. 收好啊。
今天我们要讲社交媒体和个人品牌是吗？
对了，哇！You know that I purposely keep this part until the very last minute.
Yeah.
因为哈 Andrew 哈经常就是在 all the English media 可以讲课讲得很好，所以我想试试看一下他到底能不能就是用中文来接受访问。
其实老实讲是华文呢是很少用，要在脑子里面翻译一下，
是是比较难的一点点，对不对？因为要翻译嘛，这块事情，所以就比较不容易哦。其实很多人都对这块东西是有点挑战的。
对，
所以今天晚上来到节目当中呢，我们今晚上的 Man's Talk 星期四哈，今天晚上很开心，邀请到就是Social Media， 应该叫你的名字，你的台词其实是很有力的。
对，是 Social Media Strategist， 就是说社交媒体。战略
战略者
战略者，对
对,
对。
但是为什么你会用这个名字呢？
我因为在in the corporate world， 我觉得 social media 本来就是一个战略，它不是一个年轻人的世界，或者是某某人的世界，是大家的世界。每个人都可以在社交媒体当中找到他们的机会，找到他们的 opportunity。So， 我觉得很多人很抗拒，对社交媒体有一点恐惧感，就是他们不知道如何去应付很多的 comments。
是，其实今天晚上我们会邀请到 Andrew 聊节目当中，其实多谢于一个人。这个人呢，就是因为他的一举一动，他放在 Facebook 上面讲了一些话。他其实因为新加坡是个多元种族的国家嘛，一个社会也是，我们有四大民族，有华人、马来人、印度人跟others， 就是 Eurasian。然后当然我们还有其他的一些，因为再加上我们现在已经是一个开放的都市，所以呢开始有更加其他的宗教、其他的国家的朋友们居住在新加坡或在这边工作，点点滴滴啦。所以呢我们也需要更加的包容，因为它是一个 melting pot， 是一个 society 来的，所以大家都会看到可能会从不同的国家带他们自己的一些文化传统来到新加坡居住。然后我们四大种族呢在新加坡已经居住了可能是上百年了，然后呢可能有一些人可能刚刚来到新加坡，对一些文化上比较
还不了解，
还没有融入在社会里面。 对, 对，
这是个很大的问题，因为很多在以前三到五年前在新加坡居住的人，他们都
你需要可能要讲话讲大声一 点
是吧？sorry，
他避不到了。
避不到。我觉得在很多新移民当中，前三到五年来的新移民都还不了解我们多元种族文化，是怎么包容，互相包容。
是，我们都是要互相包容。讲这个东西，我觉得真的是很好的。然后今天晚上我们今天要谈的课题就是要如何在社交媒体 social media 呢运用的好，把我们的个人品牌 personal branding， 这是我就是觉得说 Andrew 用的很恰当的一个比喻来把我们自己呢做得好，好让我们在个人生活跟我们的事业呢会有那种突飞猛进的效果。
我觉得首先大家都应该对你自己个人，把你个人看把它。
You can speak in English, not
English. 就是说 ，you must look at yourself as a brand. 你要把自己当成是个品牌来管理。
是。
品牌跟 business 不一样 ，a brand and a business is different. A business is really just a process. A brand create a connection between the company and the customer. That is why whenever your name is mentioned, what comes to people's mind is very important. 就是说，你每一次你的品牌的名字讲出来的时候，被人家讲出来，人家脑子是想什么呢？好像如果我个人品牌，如果我的名字讲出去了，我十个朋友当中八个想到的东西，那个就是我个人品牌。For example， If my name is being mentioned and everybody say this guy is always late, 8 out of 10, still they said, that means late, it's your personal branding.
Wow. Talking about me, correct?
No.
I know, right. I fly you the kites all the while, so you take this opportunity to 酸笑 me. So just okay, joking, okay, just joking.
Right. 就是说个人品牌是本来就是个 perception，
是
perception 很重要。So， 品牌管理就是要 create 那个 right perception。
OK，
yeah。
然后我们大家都知道，其实我们今天讨论的一个课题是，来自职种 NTUC 有一个高层的一个干部，high position 的一个 staff， actually 留了一个 comment 在 Facebook 上面，然后他其实有一个很负面的影响吧，
对，
所以他就导致了他可能在一夜之间就被革职了。
对，这个我要用英文来讲。
是，那也是。
Oops, okay, 首先，Facebook 是个人的，it's personal， your Facebook is definitely your personal。Space, but when you are talking anything about your company, that is different. Any company will have a policy that limits you to speak anything about a company, whether is it through the press, through your friends. So, in Amy Chong's case, all right, she not only represents herself, she is representing her company because the company value of the staff is being violated by her.And she was dismissed because of the company policy.
But she only commented the situation on her personal Facebook. Right? It's not on a company Facebook or platform.
It depends on what the company stands for. NTUC stands for serving the people.
Sure.
Serving everyone. So it's unlike a bank, all right, where we serve people who has money. For example, okay, I may be wrong, but a bank serves people who has money and want to make more money. So it depends on the value of the company.The value of the company is not being displayed by the behavior, the company can dismiss you.
Oh, okay.
All right. So, of course, having said that, each company should have their own social media policy, 就是社交媒体的那些guidelines, 怎么讲？
守则。
守则，对。对。But very few companies have. Very, very few companies have.And they should.
你看哦，在我们平面媒体哦，就是 traditional media 里面呢，我们都会有一个比如说我们每次做媒体的，我们要去接受访，我们去访问人的话，采访人的话，我们都得去到 the PR department， public relations affairs department itself， 他们就会公布 official so called official news and the protocol 那种消息 and stuff like that。但是你看现在 social media， 我难道没有需要有这个样的 department 出来吗？或者是这样的人？
这就是关键所在。我觉得现在社交媒体哦，给很多人一个平台去发表他们个人的意见。
是。
And 有些人已经超越他们的 responsibility， 他们不应该讲的也会去讲。
OK， 讲讲呢？ Okay,
怎么讲？就是说，好像比如说某某公司的总裁，几月几号会辞职？如果你在一天之前宣布的话。Then you violated the company policy.
All right, 对
right. So you're not supposed to share. You're not supposed to hint, because people can pick up your hint. So it's very important. In the past, it was very clear cut. Only the PR person will speak.
Correct.
Now everybody can be a journalist, and that is a problem. Social media make everybody a media owner.
对
right?
对。
In the past, you don't own radio, I don't own TV, so we can't speak. Now we own all the media we want.If I'm lost, I just need to post something on my Facebook, through my phone, and my friend can help me.
Correct.
So, the power of broadcasting has changed the game.
Oh, 所以现在其实是你我都是 media owner.
对，你我都是可以做，哪里都可以做 media owner， and 我们可以做播音员。
We provide the content.
Correct. We provide content. So broadcasting is no longer just mainstream. Because it's not only the press and the media. Today, everybody is a broadcaster. That is a problem.
所以就是为什么也有一些人就是滥用了社交媒体，然后一夜成名。
对，有很多东西都是 back to basic。如果你某某一件事你不可以在朋友之间讲呢，你社交媒体根本不可以随不乱发言。对，so You have to use common sense， 这是很基本的。
OK， 但是问题是哦，可以打个比方讲说，我不觉得我是公众人物啦 ，I'm not in the public figure， 因为我就觉得说我只是在，我只是喜欢做节目哎，所以我凭着我的热忱来做节目。
嗯，
但是今天我是1988的 VJ， 所以呢，我在我的 Facebook 上面讲我的个人的东西，或者甚至说我可能我跟同事之间的一些，我跟说哦，我可能 interview Andrew， 然后私底下我觉得 Andrew 是一个不是很怎么样的一个人，打比方讲啦。所以我就在 Facebook 这样讲的话，是 Today I have an interview with a guest of mine. I don't really like him as a person. 这样公司对我来讲有没有权利，就是警告我呢，还是 dismiss 我呢？
如果公司有一个守则的话，
嗯，
那个守则很清楚的，你不可以发表个人意见，好像对你们的客人的 guest 发表意见，那就是不对。如果他们没有讲的话，就是 gray area. Okay, but even if you put it is still your personal opinion against someone, all right? Because it's your opinion, because you can prove it that your personal experience tells you that I didn't have a good experience with this person.
Yeah.
Okay. But if you are speaking to a group of people and it's a big group of people and your company is serving the same group of people, that is the difference.
Oh, so that's a conflict of interest.
Conflict of interest and also the value of the company dictates that you have to behave in a certain way.
Okay, there's this particular person on my Facebook that I really detested a lot.
Okay,
I cannot block him. I cannot block him also because I'm just afraid if I block him, then you'll realize that I block him, then it doesn't look very good. Because in terms of business dealing wise, we still have some dealing with one another. But I keep having, you know, the four letter words on the Facebook, and then say I hate this person, F this person, whatever this person.
Yes. 其实，Everybody has the right to say anything on your Facebook or on your LinkedIn or your Twitter.
Yes.
But you got to be careful of the choice of words because it reflects badly on your brand. First of all, number one. Okay? Because no one will use vulgar language openly in public places. And social media is actually a public space. It's a social public place. So, first of all, I don't like to make friends.That uses vulgar language frequently.
Sure.
That's number one. And I try not to put them under my close friends list so that I don't see their updates so often. Because I don't want to read their updates every morning and be affected by it.
Yeah, precisely. Right? I think so also.
Yeah. So you can remove certain people from your feed if you want.
Okay.
Okay, so that's one way. And if you have to connect the person, there's nothing really much you can do. Okay. I had one experience in the past. I added someone in Malaysia, and this person sent me his 10 commandments of making friends. This is a true case. No? He tell you what he expect of you on Facebook before he accept you. You have to say yes to all his 10 questions, then he can accept you as friend. And one of them is that you cannot sell him anything. You cannot post anything on his wall.
Mm-hmm.
You cannot do this, cannot do that. So he said, can you do it? If you can, you say yes, you send back this document to me.I accept your friendship.
Okay.
So it's very strange, very, very peculiar, but I think everybody has some rules of making friends.
Correct.
And sometimes it's good to make known that rule.
Can I accept this call?
Okay, can I accept? So even on Facebook pages by the company, they also have rules. So house rules are very important.
So you keep mentioning about these rules that we company should have it. Can you share with us what are the rules?
They are rules of value. So if let's say your company is supposed to represent speed, supposed to represent reliability,
yes.
You have to conduct yourself to be a reliable person and to have good speed. So you can't talk anything about a company without clearance. And all these are actually common sense.
Mm-hmm.
So for example, Dell has this rule that every staff all over the world on social media, as long as you see someone asking for Dell's help, you have to help the person. And they have a format. They have a format for every staff to help the person. First of all, you introduce your name, where you work, what department you work for, and then try to help this person. If there's a link, you can share, if there's a number you can give to the person, and at the end, you always say, this is just my opinion. All right. But it's very good. Because of this policy,Dell has created a perception that Dell has all the customer service all over
the world.
So a policy is not meant to limit your staff, it's meant to free your staff. And that is one of the key points I talk about in my book, Social Media 247.
Wow. That's a very good, I think that's a very good policy. And you managed to capture that in your new book.
Correct. You know, okay. A lot of people heard about policy and got like, oh no, it must be a do's and don'ts. If
correct.
Your policy is do's and don'ts, you are a failure. The company is a failure because the company has never taught the staff how to make your brand alive. Brands are alive because of people. And if your staff has more creativity to make the company more approachable, you win more customers.
So, how can we excel well in our personal branding or even our career?
Yeah, back to personal branding, number one is that we got to select the right platform we want ourselves to be in.
Okay.
So, not your favorite platform, but the people you want to connect. So, for example, if I like to connect with people who are very good thought leaders, there's one place that I like to be. That's Quora, Quora.com. These are all the people who are very smart. They can answer a lot of questions about a lot of things. I want to know these people. I must be there.
Okay.
So that's number one. And know why you want to be there. Do you want to do PR or do you want to let people recognize you? You must know your objective.
Okay.
So, 个人品牌是一个很有趣、很好玩的过程。
是。
You know, and it's more than social media. You also need to write a book. You also need to serve charity. You need to be on mainstream media like E98. All right.Everything is a sum total of everything.
But Andrew, not everyone are just like you.
I didn't start overnight as well. 6-7 years, it slowly built up. You see, the thing is this. 见报或者 interview by media, okay? One interview may not mean much.
Correct.
But after a while, a lot of series of it form a story. So, 每件事情都是有一个开始。
你看，如果今天哦，因为 Andrew 今天是一个作者，他是一个训练师，他是个讲师，所以呢，他今天接受访问或者是什么，他是很自然的东西嘛。
对，
今天如果我只是一个 admin clerk 而已，或者是我只是一个公司的 small fly 打工仔的话，
这样的话，个人品牌，你的战略就应该你要去做多参加 networking session, so that you train yourself to speak confidently.To one person, and after that, to two person, to three person, concurrently. And after a while, you'll find that speaking is your natural self.
Do you mean by Toastmaster?
Toastmaster is, it's a bit later.
Okay.
You got to train yourself to talk socially, confidently to a few people.
Okay.
First of all, you must not be shy to meet new people. That's number one. So after that, if you are confident, you go to Toastmasters.
Uh-huh.
And after that, your other chance will come. Okay. You must always look upon you as a brand itself.And ask for help. That's what networking is all about.
Yes, correct.
No one knows everything, so you gotta ask an expert. Okay?
I gotta know Andrew on social media,
that's
so
right.
Facebook.
So for myself, I know I'm not very good, I'm not very confident in Mandarin. Certain words, I gotta ask Nick. Means I gotta ask, you have to 下苦功。
了解。
Yeah.
所以还有什么东西我们是可以用 social media 来 build 我们的 personal branding, 让我们在找工作啊或者生意比较好呢？
Okay.When you have work, and you may have certain milestones, certain major achievement at work, know how to show it off on social media. For example, you are involved in an advertisement and it's a TV ad. You must remember to save a copy on your own YouTube. That's number one. Are you a designer? You must keep your design on Flickr because those are your design. All right. It can be your work in progress. Your final copy may become company's property, but a lot of work in progress you can still keep.And if you have done interviews before, alright, and you are a writer, please write a blog. Show off your talent on social media and people will find you.
Are you sure?
Yes, you have to do that. So the first thing that you need to learn is to sign a profile on LinkedIn because that is the business social network.
But what is LinkedIn all about? It's only for people like you who want to do business.
No, it's not. Anyone who...interact with people, PMETs, and you give name card, you collect name card, you should
correct.
Be on LinkedIn.
Oh.
I share to you how I find people.
Okay.
Whenever I get a new name card, I will go on LinkedIn, I check this person whether in or not. If it's in, I add you add me, I don't keep a name card anymore because we are connected. If I take your name card, I find you, I can't find you, I will invite you. If you join, I will connect, I also don't keep a name card. But if I can't find you, I invite you, you don't join,Okay, I keep my name card. That means those name card I keep is dinosaur.
Okay, thank
okay.
you. Now I know, I hope I don't fall under that dinosaur group.
Yes, because once I find you on LinkedIn, even if you change job, I am informed.
Oh, that's very true, huh?
Yes. and you don't no longer need to send me an email. I'm so happy to meet you. This is my last day, you know.
Yes, and so on. Correct.
I believe we got this out email every time.
Yes.
And once you're on social media, you don't have to because they send out a notice on your behalf.
Are you sure?
To all the people you're connected to in social media. So when you change job, right, your status is changed and everybody will get a notice that you have changed your status. If you're on Flexo, even better. Flexo writes on top of Outlook so that once you change your destination, they send out email to everyone.
Can you please share with us what are the social media that we need to be in other than Facebook and Twitter?
Facebook, Twitter, LinkedIn. Right now got a very, very 新宠, which is Pinterest.
Serious?
Pinterest has overtaken Twitter as the second most referral site. That means there are more people pinning images, and when you click on the images, it doesn't just enlarge, it went straight into the source where the image come from.
Wow, that is very dangerous eh.
It's good because if you are a company who sells product and if you're a company who sells some consultancy services, all you do is to create nice pictures, good posters, people like to keep, and the more they pin, you create more backlinks back to your site.
Okay.
And Google count the number of backlinks that go back to your site and it give a higher ranking.
Wow, this is very technical eh.
It's technical, but few people know it. So today, let me share to you something. This is important. Because when people like your poster, they keep pinning, and my friend keep pinning from me, their friends keep pinning from them, you will have more and more people come to know you.
Are these being captured in your books also?
That's right.
So that I can also found them in your books right. So.
I have 34 chapters I talk about from A to Z, from very, very fundamental to very, very advanced. Mm-hmm. So it's not a book to be read from cover to cover. If you already know something about social media, go straight into the implementation or the planning part. If you are new, you go to the basic, which is the fundamental. So there's something for everyone. I'm just happy that in about 9 to 10 days time, it should hit the bookstore. Social Media 247.
So if I want to find this book, where can I Google it or how to find the website?
My site has a pre-order, social247media.com, social247media.com. But 2nd November onwards, you should be able to find in all major bookstores.
Oh, 2nd November.
Yes.
Thank you for choosing this date. It's my wedding anniversary.
All right.
thank you. No, but I'm just very curious as in like, why you use social247media?
In my book, I mentioned that social media is a lifestyle and lifestyle will not stop. Lifestyle doesn't mean you 8 to 8, I'm this person. At night and become another person. 247 in a corporate world, it means 24 hours, 7 days a week.
Correct.
It means never stop.
Yeah.
It's a lifestyle. We never stop. I can tell you, we human beings, we love to connect. How many times have you been to a new country on a tour and the first thing you check into the hotel, you take out your handphone, is to ask yourself, got Wi-Fi?
Yeah.
Right. And what you do, you take all the pictures and you share them on Facebook. We just can't stand not being able to connect. And social media is about connection. It's about talking. It's not about blasting. It's not about self-glorification. It's about sharing.
So you see, we share so much about social media, what we can do and how we can leverage on it to enhance our personal life itself. But are there anything that we should not be doing or we should minimize these actions?
Basic stuff would be do not talk anything bad about your competitor because it affects bad on you.
Mm-hmm.
Do not engage in any lengthy discussion. Because after a while, it gets more and more personal.
Lengthy as in,
if you know the person, we talk offline.
Mm-hmm.
If you don't know the person, it is fruitless to keep on engaging in a discussion, in an argument, because it will be no end. There will be no moderator to say who wins. So you're just wasting time. I think the best kind of discussion is for people who know each other. At least we discuss, even if we don't agree with each other, we discuss in respect.
Correct.
Out of respect. We don't attack each other. If I don't know you, and I don't agree with you, after a while, I become very personal.
Correct.
Yeah.
Very
so,
true.
So never engage in a lengthy discussion with people you don't know. Okay, that's very simple. Number two, anything to do with race, religion, politics, don't touch. You can still get into trouble by the police.
Yeah, especially if you're in Singapore, correct?
That's right. So if police can trace the start of SMS, they can definitely trace the start of a Facebook.
The IP address.
That's right. Okay. So be smart, be social.
Okay.
Actually, once you're friendly, you will never have this problem. Once you're a social person, you never have this problem.
Okay, now, can you take my Facebook as a case study?
Okay.
Let's go to my Facebook now. Yeah, I know that you will never...
Okay, cool.
Okay, let me click to my Facebook. Can you tell me what can I do, or what have I done right, or what have I done wrong or what can
I improve. Is this your profile, right?
This is my personal page itself. This is my personal Facebook. If you have a Facebook fan page, okay. But the fan page is miserable.
Can you scroll down to see how many fans
sure.
you have?
Sure, I have only 2,000.
Oh, that's a lot already.
Huh? That's a lot.
That's a lot already because Facebook average, they say a person has only like 200-300 friends.
Okay.
So you're already 7 times over. Okay, I think first of all is that, you know, it's very easy. I believe, Nick, you are a media celebrity. You know, you have a lot of shows to host and so on. See, sometimes we keep sharing the same old thing.
Yep.
Sometimes we got to share lessons we learn from any events that we go to.
Mm-hmm.
So if there's no special lessons you have learned, it's not inspiring. And even though it's a grand event, no point sharing because
sure.
it is just like self-advertisement.
Definitely.
So for example, if you find a VIP of your event they're hosting very, very, very friendly,
mm-hmm.
and you think that everyone should learn from this person, you share about that story and people will feel connected. Yeah. I also have met people who are very high up there but they are very friendly.
Sure.
So you create a connection socially.
Okay.
Yeah, so that is one. And number two is that always have 20 best, best friends that is willing to introduce you to their best friends. 20 only. Imagine if you have a fan page and you encourage 20 friends to invite 50 of their good friends to
okay.
your page, you will guarantee yourself that you have a lot of genuine people who like your page.
So can you please be one of my 20?
Sure, no problem.
I show you my fan page. It's a miserable fan page. I think so. After so many months in Chobama, I find that my fan page is so miserable. Yeah, this is what I have on my fan page itself.
Okay, you need brand ambassador. You need people who like what you do.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and you definitely need to have more pictures for group event and encourage people to tag themselves.
Oh, tag themselves? Why
tag? Yeah, tag themselves on the pictures that you have taken,
mm-hmm.
so that their friends see that picture. So imagine you have a group picture of 30 people. And everybody tag. Let's say 25 of them tag. Your picture will be shared on 25 different profiles.
Oh. Okay.
Then their friends, the friends of these people will be curious, hey, where is this event? It is so cool. They click on the picture, they go back to your page and they end up liking your page. That is one.
Okay,
important.
Okay.
Okay, and have more than one administrator.
Huh?
Have more than one administrator. Don't be your own administrator. Have someone else become your administrator. So sometimes when you're doing shows and you have a very good friend who are in the same show, he can comment on the spot on your behalf. So instead of after the event, end of the day, then you post, you can post it on the spot and you encourage comment on the spot as well.
Oh, wow, that's a good one.
Yeah. So you can do spot. And of course, if you have Twitter, link your Twitter to your page so that whenever you tweak, it links here. Whenever you share that, it links to Twitter. And also link to your LinkedIn. So it's multiple linking.
I'm a dinosaur. Can you help me to link?
You have to invest in this software called Hootsuite. You can link it very, very primitively. Just link Twitter to here. And whatever you share is interchanged on both sides.
Okay.
So these are the things that you can get overseas fans just by linking Twitter to your fan page.
Oh, okay, okay.
Okay. And the second thing is this. Log on Facebook as your page and like other page and comment on other page so that they will drive traffic to your page.
Oh, I log on as my page.
Okay. And then you go and like other big page, go there and contribute very good value comments.
Sure.
And you'll get noticed. People will come back to you and like you.
Oh.
Yeah. So
thank you.
Follow these three simple steps and you will see it grow, definitely.
Thank you. Yeah. I never know that there's so many principles behind a good social media branding and stuff like that itself.
Yeah.
So how long do you take to learn all these things?
Actually, to be honest, I'm 45 this year. I start to go on Facebook only in 2008. At the end, that means at the end, almost I was almost going to be 41 years old. Okay? So I took 4 years to catch up with all the things I need to know because I'm considered a dinosaur.
Mm-hmm.
And 4 years later, I write a book.
Wow.
So if I can do it, you can do it. So if you're 40 plus, there's no excuse. Because my mother, 60 plus, also on Facebook.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Because you only need to press.
Yeah.
And you see, even old folks, whenever they see relative, they're very excited.
Hey, correct.
Yeah. And once they find one, it's just like primary school friends. Once you find one, you find the rest. So everyone has this need to get connected.
Correct.
Once they know how to do it, it gets very addictive.
So in fact, I should learn from you saying that instead of fearing social media, I should use it as a what's that called? I should overcome the fear and use it to maximize our personal branding.
You have to give us some control, but be sensible. If anything you don't want to share, don't share. So if you're not comfortable sharing some thoughts, then don't do it. Some people don't show picture to their children. It's perfectly understandable. Do what you're comfortable with. Okay, and if you don't want people outside to see your profile, remember to set the setting to friends only and not public.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I want to ask you one question.
Mm-hmm.
If this question is that, if I want to, if let's say if I attended some event itself, but I do not want my boss or my colleagues to know my whereabouts, then how?
The best is you don't post it. Or you join those special portal called like PUF. PUF is really for your own friends. You only update your friends and you don't update anybody else. So you select who you want to be in your circle.
Okay. No. What I mean is that let's say that this is a good option, but let's say I attended an event, let's say I attended a seminar. But you know, I have friends who took the pictures and then they tag me, tag.
Okay, then you have to set a function that you must approve those tagging.
Yes. There's such a function in Facebook.
Yes. So that means that everyone who tag anything about you, you get to see first, you get to reject or approve.
You can
do it. So that's number one. Number two is that you can gently tell whoever to take a picture, hey, please, when you upload, don't tag me. But the best is that you set your own setting. Protect yourself, you must approve those tagging. Then you will be okay.
Thank you, Andrew, for sharing so much with us this evening itself.
Yeah, it's been a pleasure. First time on your show. Okay, I only speak 10% Chinese. 以后我会更加努力。
终于啊，因为我每次请他上节目，我都放飞机，我都会不见景，别人害怕。其实我们讲了半年了，没有多过半年了，我们从去年11月讲到现在，终于在一周年的时候，我们终于见面了。所以世界上很多东西，好东西是值得等待的。 谢谢你这样的推荐。是的，如果你们大家对 Andrew 真的有兴趣的话，你可以来到我们的 Facebook， 然后去找 Andrew Chow， 或者是到我们的 1988的官方网页上面呢，也会看到 Andrew Chow 我们的 Brand Ambassador， 然后去点击他，然后去 like 他在他的 Facebook 上面，或者是去 Twitter， 或者是 LinkedIn 这些地方全部都可以找到他。当然，如果你对 Andrew 的新书有兴趣的话，那就搜索 247 Media， 你可以去 www.social247media.com 可以去点击。 因为最新的书要出来了，那就是在11月2号就会在新加坡各大书局会找到这本书。如果 they are not even staying outside of Singapore, then how?
Outside Singapore, you can actually make an order on my web and it'll be sent to you. Just make a payment on PayPal and it'll be sent to you.
Hey, I realized that on your book, on the PayPal, on the website, there's this part that said if you want an autograph book.
Oh yeah, all pre-order will be autographed. So when the book is out, I'll autograph and I'll send it to you.
So my book will be autographed also,
yes,
right?
Yes, definitely.
So must I go to your house and pick it up?
Oh, no need. We will send to... I have a big launch on the 8th of November on National Library.
Okay.
So if you want to come by, you can collect your book there and join a lot of other people for some lucky draw and a talk. If you want me to send to your house, no problem as well.
So for more information, do log on to www.social247media.com. Thank you, Andrew.
Yes,
thank you.
Pleasure. 谢谢.
So 你会再回来，对不对？
对，一定会再回来.
随传随到吗？
对。
才怪啊！
Must be on next program.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
所以所有1988的同事。 Andrew 是我的人 ，OK， 因为他自己讲是来我的节目而已，所以 Jerry 啊，或者是阳光有节目的，因为啊，我都是在10点过后我才有空，所以他这样。Mom said to tell you， 我可能不可以值这个班了。那你快去哪个时段？Off the line， 我们再讲。OK，好了，晚间时间已经10点35分了，非常感谢你们收听今天晚上的《Man's Talk》， 稍后时间我们再回来。今天晚上的时光，你好，坐在我身旁的是今天晚上的特别嘉宾，我非常感谢我们的 Andrew， 我们的 Social Media Strategist 来到我们节目当中，他也是即将了，我相信他这本新书也将会成为新加坡的畅销书。 之一，预知更多详情的话，你可以到我们的官方网页，那就 www.social247media.com， 或者是你可以到我们的 Facebook 去找我们的 Andrew Chow， 就可以找到他了。所有的资料都可以看到，都可以找到。 在 social media 上面都可以找到他。
对，谢谢。
其实你去 Google 就可以找到他。哎，你没有那个什么叫做什么Andrew Chow Wikimedia 的 page
哦，还没有，我现在找人在跟我 set up 一个，因为自己不可以写自己嘛。
真的没？不可以自己写自己的？
自己写自己，要别人写你。
哦，
对。
哎 ，so easy for you。
Yeah. To write Wikipedia, there are only 5,000 over people qualified to contribute article on Wikipedia. That means they don't want any selling, they don't want any advertising. It must be pure facts, and it must be supported by a source. They call it citation. That is why it's so difficult to write.
Oh.
So if they say, I'm born in this day, they must prove it. I've been to this school, they must prove it. Yes, I've been on this newspaper, they must prove it. They must have a link. Or they have an ACRA number or a microfilm from a library or something like that to prove that whatever they say is correct.
Wow, so I wish that you appear on that very soon.
But of course, when they say, someone say I write a book, they can definitely prove it. So that's the only one.
You want to come to my show? Want to prove it? No issue. Just call me. I'll give you the video clips.
I think I will start to write Wiki soon. Hopefully, yeah.
Yeah, can you please mention my name?
Of course, definitely. After I write one, I can write for anybody. Yeah. And Wikipedia, just one last thing is that I write, people can also contribute to the same article. And that's why it's so amazing. Social media, anyone can contribute.
So remember to tag on social media. Yes. 突然好想你送给你这首歌曲，那就是五月天的。如果你想我的话，去 social media 找我咯。
新的一天，新的开始。